Now we are going to multiply decimals by 10, 100 and 1000. Okay? Very easy steps to begin with. We have a decimal point. If we are going to multiply, we move the decimal point to the right. When we multiply, move the decimal point to the right. When we divide, move the decimal point to the left. And it's easy as that. Let's take this example. 15.23 times 10. Take the decimal point. When we move by a power of 10, we are moving the decimal point one place. Just like this. Move the decimal place there. And now our answer becomes 152.3. And depending on the power of 10 that we use, the number of zeros lets us know how many decimal places to move the answer. So, the decimal place. So we have one zero in the 10, therefore we're only moving it one time. Let's take 0.25 times 1000, we have three zeros. So that means we're going to take this decimal place and move it to the right three times. One, two, three. Now as you can see here, there's an empty space. So what do? We use something called annexing zeros. It means adding zeros when you need. Therefore, the answer would be, we put the zero there, and the decimal place then comes afterwards. Now, we don't need this decimal place because it's a whole number, it's 250. And 250 and 250.0 are the same thing, okay? Now then, let's change these numbers into divide. Okay, starting with this one. As I said, we move it to the left. So we're going to start from here, move it to the left one, two, three times. Okay, now then, even before you begin the question, sometimes you can add the zeros to begin with. Okay, just add as many zeros as you like. Okay, now then, when we come to dividing by 1000, we see we have three zeros. And that's three decimal places. So we've moved the decimal point three times and the new decimal point goes there. So now we know our new answer is 0.00025. Okay? Let's take another example. Let's just take 5 divided by 10. The decimal place, we don't have one visible, but we actually do have one. It's here. And now we are going to take it one time and move it there. And when the decimal place comes there, now the answer is 0.5, but we add the zero in front. So it's 0.5, okay? Now, I have another example to do, which my help is going to do. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, now we're gonna do 1.29 multiplying by 100. When we multiply, we go right. So we do 100 two times. 1, 2, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0,
is we simply take our time, look, evaluate, do it again. You see, now we noticed, and that is an excellent example. Hassan, start over.
Okay.
To the right, that's okay, carry on.
Okay. You go right, one and two. It equals 129. And this one, the point is right here. We divide, so we go left, one time, two, four, one, five.